Minute Maid Park in Houston. Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the San Diego Padres taking on the Houston Astros. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. So, almost ready to get underway. And towing the slab in this one, Justin Verlander. And as usual with him, Singy, I think we can expect plenty of strikeouts.
Yeah, Boogie's racked up over 3,000 strikeouts in his career, so expect to see more of the same in this one.
And the pitch. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Duvall flashes the leather on the running catch. Let's take a look at the Padres lineup. And Chris, this group has been struggling to put up runs lately.
Well, they haven't been on base a ton, and even when they are, they haven't been hitting very well with the runners on base. So they need a guy or two to really step up, have some quality at-bats, hit according to the situation, and sort of break out of this. I think if they do, the rest of this lineup will follow.
Fernando Tatis Jr. to hit here. Duvall drifts towards it, pulls it down, and there's two gone. Juan Soto now. Here's a high fly ball out to center. And that one hops the wall. Round second, digging for third. Payton with a relay throw, and he's out. Cut down, and that ends the inning.
Well, it looks like he got a little greedy right there going for the triple. He was already in scoring position. You got to hold up right there unless you're absolutely sure. The defense says thank you very much as they head back into the dugout.
Back here in Houston and on the hill, Blake Snell. Singy, he's kind of a road warrior, yeah?
I definitely say so. You know, some guys shrink a little bit on the road. They're so used to just, you know, having the comforts of being at home and having the fans behind them. But this guy seems to thrive in adversity and being in some hostile environment. So when you have a player like this on your team that goes out there and competes, you definitely like your chances away from your home ballpark.
Goes down swinging for the strikeout. Some high cheese for strike three. Jeremy Pena up next for the Astros. Popped up. And there are two down. Now we check out the Astros lineup. One guy leading the way offensively for this club right now, Alex Bregman.
This guy had an on-base percentage of over 400 last month. That's just telling you, he's taking his walks, getting his knocks, he's finding some holes. Everything just going really well for him right now. But don't overlook the fact that that happens because he's having consistently good at-bats.
Yordan Alvarez in the box now. No balls and a strike. Next offering is fouled back. Alvarez, who's from Cuba, he grew up idolizing a future teammate, Yuli Gurriel, who is 13 years his senior. Good job to fight that one off. The next pitch misses, and the count 1-2. You know, Chris, Blake does everything right-handed except for everything he does. He locked him up, and that'll do it. The inning is over. Nothing into Houston first. We played an inning for Minute Maid Park. Scoreless on the show. Back here at Minute Maid Park, top of the second. So here's the Padres DH, Manny Machado. Verlander back to work. In the air out to center, Duvall under this one. Makes the catch, and there's one away.
Almost a loud start to the inning on that first pitch, man. He's going to want that one back, no doubt.
It's Xander Bogaerts now. That one hit to right. Tucker should have it. He's there. He's got it. And a couple of quick outs. And now it's Garrett Cooper up to him. Good contact guy, good defender. High
high in the air out to right.
Tucker puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. Three up, three down for San Diego. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. And welcome back. Here's the third baseman, Alex Bregman.
The third baseman, Alex.
The pitch.
Bregman.
Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Bregman, who had a great career at LSU. He was the seventh overall pick in 2015. He wears that number on his back, number two, and singing. He was a big Derek Jeter fan growing up. And the 0-2. And he gets Bregman. And there's one down.
Well, I think that's a case of overthinking right there. He got three straight fastballs looking in the 0-2 count just to pour it back.
Here's Kyle Tucker. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
No ball. A lot of guys would love to be taken in the first round and second overall, but Alex Bregman seems to have carried that as a chip on his shoulder over the years, not being the number one pick overall. And he's played in such a way where he's always trying to show people that he's the best, and it's translated on both sides of the ball.
And down on strikes, and there's two away. Jose Abreu up to hit. Way inside, gets out of the way.
One ball, no strikes.
And there's a strike.
This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing them down. He's settling in. You got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Got him looking. That's a strikeout. 1-2-3 go the Astros. We'll move to the third with no score. Back here in Houston, the top half of the third inning. And now the veteran catcher, Gary Sanchez. The wind of the pitch. Line drive. And there's a hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
Nice line drive to the pole side. Met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
And now here is Matthew Beck. And that one is lifted in the air. Drops into the glove. And there's one away. Now it's Trent Grisham to the plate. Good defender. He's been inconsistent offensively. In the air, right field. Tucker should have it. And it's caught for the out. Ha-Sung Kim, the next up for the Padres. 0-1 so far. That one is absolutely belted. That's back there. And that one is off the wall. Kim into second, and he's got a double.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Once in the cage, you're just hoping you get the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity. Right on top of it.
And that one lifted in the air center field. Makes the grab, and that is that.
A lot of adrenaline, we can see it right there. And sometimes you just got to let it out. That's an outstanding job of taking that, executing, and getting out of a tough inning.
Welcome back, Michael Brantley, to start things off.
No left field.
The pitch.
Michael Brantley.
And first offering is fouled off. Snell, in his seventh season, he features a four-seam fastball, a slider, a curve, and he works in a changeup. Next pitch is popped up. And out number one on the grab.
Good hard fastball up in the zone right there. They look really good coming in, but so hard to get on top of as a hitter.
Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. Chris, you look at Blake Snell's resume, a former first-round pick by the Rays in 2011, but really blossomed quickly. Cy Young in 2018, he was an all-star that year, too. And, of course, pitched for the Rays against the Dodgers in the 2020 World Series.
got the pitch that he wanted just a little bit quick. Front shoulder open, backside collapsed a little bit, and the launch angle not where he needed it to be.
Batten puts the squeeze on that one, and that is that. Astros are down quietly. Still no score.
Back here at the ballpark,
and now it's Juan Soto. And a pitch. There's a swing and a drive. That one's back there. In safely with a double, his second of the day.
He was all over that one. When you connect and it jumps off your bat like that, you're thinking double at the very least. He put a great swing on it, and man, he wasn't fooled at all. Now let's see if they can put up the first run of the game.
And Manny gets a piece.
Just missed. If he's able to connect on that, look out.
The pitch. Gets a piece, and it stays 0-2.
Man, he'd like to have that pitch back.
And that one hammered. Brantley ranging back. And that one is out of here. He circles the bases, his 27th home run of the season.
When a guy's got a real hard fastball, you can't overswing. All you've got to do is get the bat head to the spot. If you do, he supplies the power, and you'll get to jog around the bases like he did right there.
And here comes Xander Bogaerts.
Now a high fly ball out to left center.
Brantley makes the play, and there's one down.
It's a good recovery, though, after giving up the home run, allowing it to stay in the head, but going to work at the next hitter, and a tough one at that.
In the air, out towards right center. Duvall settles under it, and there's two away. In today's game, you look at exit velocity as a measure of process, and if guys are hitting the ball hard, eventually the results usually follow. Gary Sanchez, he is a guy that hits the ball hard. Now the 0-1. Swing and a high fly ball in the air left field. Brantley ranging back. Gone! Gary Sanchez hits one out. Home run number 20 on the year.
That was one of those home runs where you really don't know if he got enough of it off the bat. I mean, he put a good swing on it, clearly, but I wouldn't say he really got the sweet spot on the bat. The exit velo wasn't anything too impressive, but it had all it needed for him to circle the pillows.
Stepping in, Matthew Batten. Duvall drifts towards it. He makes the grab, and that is that. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. It's now 3-0. You're dialed into the show. Back here in Houston, John Giambi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Jose Altuve. That clips the zone, 0-1.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. One down. Jeremy Pena digs in now. Swing and a miss as he was late that time. High strike two. The Astros still looking for their first hit in this one. In the air, center field. Grisham trying to get there. Makes the grab on the run. And there's two away. Now it's Yordan Alvarez. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. That one fouled off. The 0-2. Next offering popped in the air, right field. And they get the out on Alvarez. That is the third out of the inning. Astros go down 1-2-3. They trail it here 3-0. Back here at Minute Maid Park, we go to the top of the fifth. Here's the center fielder, Trent Grisham. The wide to kick the pitch. Foul ball.
You know, these Padres, digging into their numbers, have to be happy with the swings they're taking. They have 5 extra base hits on the stat sheet so far, and that tells me they're seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well.
No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And a quick out number one. Right. And now the right fielder, Ha-Sung Kim, 1-for-2. This one high in the air to left center. Duvall tracks it down for the out.
With all those extra base hits, it's easy to think we're going to see that trend continue the rest of the game. They seem to be really locked in at the plate.
In the air, left field. Brantley makes the grab, and that's the inning. Padres down in order, but they lead it 3-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And here now is the Astros cleanup hitter, Alex Bregman. And a pitch. And a good fastball to start him off at strike one. Strike two. The wind of the pitch. Foul ball left side. He'll see another.
The idea was right. Looking to locate that fastball up and in. He just missed his spot a little bit.
Gets a piece and stays alive. 0-2. Battling here as he fouls it away. Here's the 0-2. He goes down looking.
No, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a called ball or anything. I just think he was flat out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
Tucker in the box with one away as he takes ball one. Popped up to the left, into foul ground. Snell makes the catch, and there's two down. Two outs, base is empty. And next to hit for Houston, Jose Abreu.
Abreu.
And first offering is fouled off. Jose Abreu, one of those guys with kind of a quirky number 79. It was a number his mother chose for him way back when. She said, pick a unique number and make it yours. Pitch. Foul ball still 0-2. The Stros hitless so far in the game. Fights that one away and the count remains 0-2. And down on strikes he goes. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Nothing doing there for Houston. They trail in this one 3-0. And welcome back. Top of the sixth inning. Here's Juan Soto. Verlander back to work. That one blasted deep to right. Tucker going back on this one. Looking up, makes the catch up against the wall.
Ooh, he was all over that first pitch fastball. Just barely missed it. Man, this guy was ready to hit.
Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. Brantley makes the grab, two down. Here's Xander Bogaerts. Swings here and blasts one left field, and it's off the wall. The throw in, and he'll pull into second with two gone.
Bat fact, that one registered at 105 miles per hour, man. That is smoking, and these days you hear it all the time, but the numbers just don't lie. You can drive a ball like that.
Swing, and this one's blasted. It's got a chance. And caught on the warning track. No runs, one hit, a double, no errors, and one man left. 7-8-9, two up in the home half of the inning. It's the Padres 3 and the Astros nothing. Back here in Houston, here we go, bottom six. And stepping in for the Astros, Michael Brantley. Swings and misses. And it's 0-1. Now 1-1. And a 1-1. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Struck him out looking. No messing around with the pitch calling in that sequence right there. Four pitches, all fastballs.
Yeah, and that makes me think that was the plan before the at-bat even started. If you think you can simply just beat a guy with only your fastball, why throw him anything else until he shows you he can handle it?
Next offering is in for a strike.
The offense needs to start showing some fight against this starter. He's doing his thing out there. They're going to have to push back at some point and make him work a little bit harder.
Kim calls it in, two away. Two outs, base is empty. And now, Martin Maldonado. Next pitch is popped up. Sanchez settles under this one, and that's the inning. Astros are down quietly. Still down 3-0. Parker Mashinsky will take over here.
And he's got a big-time breaking ball to contend with. Hitters going to have to pick it up early if they're going to have any chance.
And he deals. Sanchez down the box. Comes up empty with a swing there. Activity in the bullpen. Phil Maton up and loosening in the pen. Neris getting loose as well. Swing and blast one down the line. It's gone if it's fair. Body hooks foul.
That's a really good pass of the ball right there. Just a little bit too quick. He's got to find a way. Just let it travel. I hear more.
Hammers that one deep left field and forget it. His second home run of the game, and they tack one on the board. It's 4-0. Singy, the ball is jumping off his bat.
Yes, it is. Tons of loud contact. Man, it's been impressive. No matter how this outing ends, that pitch is going to haunt him for a while. An 0-2 mistake. That's supposed to be a pitch out of the zone. He left it in a spot that the hitter could do some damage with, and that's exactly what he did.
And now, Matthew Batten. That's a laser base hit.
Now, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. First pitch fastball in a great spot to do some damage, and he squared it up nicely.
And now, in the air, right field, pretty well struck. To the warning track, makes the catch. Throw behind the runner, and they got him doubled off.
Definitely a weird play right there, and it changes the outlook of the inning completely. Nice job by the defense to take advantage and get two outs out of it, but on the flip side, I have to think they're going to have some discussions. Probably some lessons.
Well struck left field, and it hits the fence. He's in with a double, and that's his second double of the night.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything, really good balance, nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
Crushed in the air. Left center field. Way back there. No doubt about it. He made him pay for that one. And they tack on to their lead. It's 6-0.
Love to see a hitter aggressive on the first pitch of an at-bat. You watch him from the on-deck circle, so when you step in the box, you're ready to pull the trigger wherever it's at. Really good job by the hitter. Total conviction on that swing.
Jose Urquidy taking over on the mound.
And as relievers go, he's not a big strikeout guy. He tries to force weak contact, so command and execution are huge for him.
He swings and hits a fly ball, center field. Dubon, long run on his horse. And that one hops the wall. Soto rounds second, heads for third. The relay, throw is low, and he can't pick it.
Challenged him with the fastball right in the heart of the zone, and he was clearly ready to jump all over it.
Runner at third, two gone. Here's Machado. Now fly ball to right center. No trouble here, puts it away for the out. That is the inning. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. It's now a 6-0 ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Welcome back. Bottom of the seventh. Here's the Astros leadoff man, Jose Altuve. Right through there for his strike.
Pretty amazing, his first pitch strike percentage, over 90%. You know you're getting something in the zone first pitch. So if you're a hitter, you got to be ready to let it fly, even though you had a lot of success on that first pitch of the at-bat.
The punch out there, and he's down on strikes for the second time today. Now it's the shortstop, Jeremy Pena.
Shortstop, Jeremy Pena.
Swing and a ball popped up. Tatis drifts towards it. He makes the catch, and there's two down. Here's Yordan Alvarez.
Batter, number 44, designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez.
That's in there. It's 0-1.
No balls, one strike.
And there's a foul ball. The Astros yet to pick up a hit here. Swing and a ball popped up. Batten on his way over. He's got it. And that'll do it. The perfection continues. 21 straight have been retired. Eighth inning coming up. It's the Padres 6 and the Astros nothing. Back here at the ballpark, new inning getting started. And now the shortstop, Xander Bogaerts. The pitch. Out to center. Dubon makes the catch, and there's one down. And here's the first baseman, Garrett Cooper.
Almost drove one out of here last time up. Flied out to the warning track.
That one ripped. Hits the fence. Fires the second too late, and he's got a double.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Just missed out on a home run right there, but he certainly hit it hard enough. Just didn't have the right launch angle to carry it over the wall, but still an excellent swing of the bat.
Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. Brings it in, two-way down. And the batter now, Matthew Batten, 1-for-3. That's out to center field. Dubon pulls it down, and that ends the inning. Padres lead one. They lead it, though, 6-6. Here in Houston, onto the bottom of the eighth, and a pitch.
Allen, Rick Penn.
And first offering is fouled off.
Now, there's a pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if he can mix that in whenever he wants.
And that one fouled off. The 0-2. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. 0-2 now. Called strike three on the fastball, and that ran back over the inner half.
Well, they've had a great plan of attack for tonight. I mean, finding all the holes in his swing and his approach, just frustrating for him up there. You strike out a guy three times in the game, I think that guy's got to go back and really study some video with his hitting coach, figure out how they're beating him, make this adjustment really quick, because word will get around the league in a hurry.
Next offering is fouled back. One down, base is empty. Oof. That one went straight back and got our ump right in the mask. Let's hope he's okay. Pitch misses there. The count now 2-2. Hard hit, right side. He'll do it himself. 2 up, 2 down.
Man, he's getting really close to this thing right now. Only 4 outs left, but it's going to be tough to get.
Back to right. Kim makes the catch, and that'll do it. 1-2-3 go the Astros. They still find themselves down. 6-0. So here comes Ryan Pressly to the mound.
Well, he's been excellent against left-handed hitters this year, and that's his first test. This looks like a good move to the pen in terms of the matchup.
And a pitch. And first offering is fouled off. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swung on, belted. That's back. He can't get there. It's a base hit. And he makes it into third with a leadoff triple.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. What a really beautiful swing on that pitch right there. Just didn't quite have the combination of launch angle and exit velocity to drive it over the wall. But when you can beat a center fielder like that.
And that one is lifted in the air. And there's one away. So man aboard, one down, and it's Tatis at the plate. He's already homered in this game. Out towards right center field, Dubon turns, moving to his left. That's down, one hops off the wall. Around second now, going for three. On to third, save! And a run comes in to score.
Everything came together for him. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you gotta make them pay.
Now the youngster Juan Soto. That one hammered center field. That's back. Gone! Juan Soto goes deep. His 29th of the season, and they add on. 9-0.
Well, he put a really nice swing on that one, and everything was on time, took a direct path to the ball, excellent extension, and just drove it out of here. And nothing better than when the ball jumps off your bat like that.
The Astros turn to a new arm on the mound, Phil Maton.
Things got to be a little tough coming in out of the pen when your guys are trailing so big on the scoreboard. It just doesn't have the same intensity to it, but he's got to find a way.
Oh, now this is blasted. Way back there, on its way, gone. Manny Machado leaves the yard. He's done it again. His second homer of the game, and they add a run. It's 10-0. He absolutely feasts on right-handed pitching and devours that one for a homer.
And you can see that's what he expects of himself. At bat after at bat, he's that confident.
Now Xander Bogaerts gets a chance to hit. Fly ball to right. Tucker pulls it in for the out. And there's two down. Two outs, base is empty. Garrett Cooper, the next up for the Padres. That's towards center. Dubon on the move. And makes the play, and that's out number three. Blake Snell heading back out for the bottom of the ninth as he'll look to make history. Back here at Minute Maid Park, we head to the bottom of the ninth. And stepping in for the Astros, Michael Brantley. That one's in there. Strike one.
Boog, I'll tell you right now, every player defensively on their toes like never before.
Swung on, popped up on the infield. Tatis makes the catch for the out. And there's one away. And now two outs away from history.
Well, I hope he gets this done. I mean, this is the kind of feat that can define a career. Hard not to root for him at this point.
The 0-1. And a foul ball.
They want to make sure they have the opportunity to put this pitcher in the history books. they are going to make the play.
Swing and a ball lifted to center field. Makes the grab, tracks it down after the long run. Two down.
26 up and 26 down. One more out for a perfect game. This is awesome, Boone.
On the verge of baseball history here, and certainly one of the most dominating pitching performances we've seen. Everyone locked in right now. A swing and a miss, and that's strike one. Here's a 1-2. Lifted in the air, right center field. And there it is, history. He's thrown a perfect game.
Just unbelievable. I was nervous up here in the booth. I can only imagine what his teammates and even he felt out there on the mound closing this thing out. Everyone will remember this perfect game, and it'll be notched in Cooperstown forever.